and there was a girl in one of the bunk beds. No one knew who she was.
Just random girl.
Nobody knew how she got there. She was just passed out in the bed, but they actually had to kick her off the bus.
My bad, Karen. I didn't mean to put you in that booth, baby. What's up, world? It's your boy, DeStorm Power, sitting here on the set of Young Hollywood. Make sure you subscribe to their network right now. All right, now, hit the subscribe button up there, over there, down there. They change it, but wherever it is, you make sure you hit that button and make sure you subscribe to me, too. DeStorm, I'm out. Deuces.
RJ here, hanging out at the Young Hollywood studio with the one and only DeStorm Power. How are you?
What's up, man? I'm good.
What's up? All right.
It's good to be here.
I gotta get a what's up, world. You gotta tell to our audience. Let's hear it.
What's up, world? It's Hollywood, baby.
I like it. So how did that start? The tagline that everyone knows when you watch his videos, they all start with the what's up, world.
Well, you know what it was, right? Well, no one ever asked that question. That's good, that's good. But what started what's up, world was I had a video way back in the day, and I noticed, like, on YouTube, it's not just America, it's not just places. And then people would complain and be like, well, I'm from Lithuania. Can you say what's up to me, too? And I was like, you know what? What's up, world? So I just started talking to everybody because everybody watches the videos from all over the world. So it just became a thing. And then everybody was like, oh, I like the way you say it. They started making fun of it. So I said, I'm going to say it every time. What's up, world? What's up, world? What's up, world?
And the name now, because we hear Day, we hear DeStorm, we hear DeStorm Power. Like, what is it? You're like Diddy, man.
It's I got to
like
change it up. Like, you know how they had Jay-Z, Jigga, Hova, J-Hova. You know, you gotta be new every once in a while. So I don't know what I'm going to be tomorrow.
Let's create a new one right now. Young Hollywood here in the studio. Okay. What's the new name going to be?
It'll be Day Power. We'll just take the storm out. The Power. So they'll say it wrong. They'll mess it up and stuff like that.
RJ here hanging out at the Young Hollywood studio with Day Power.
There we go. Holla
I like that. You heard it here first. That's a good one, how it's going like that.
No, it's good, though.
So I want to talk about the evolution, because, like, you've blown up in a major way. I mean, over a million subscribers, hundreds of millions of views now. That's, like,
serious
numbers.
It's like, you don't feel it, though. You still don't see it until you walk out the street and people say stuff to you. You're like, oh, yeah, that's right.
So what's, like, the one video, if everyone out there has to check out a DeStorm video, what's your favorite one?
Ah, wow, I got a couple of favorites, but if it was a challenge, I would say check out jumping out of a plane.
Man, I jumped out of a plane!
That was one of the hardest ones because I literally actually took the plane up and then jumped out and rapped on my way to the ground. So if it's a challenge you want to check out, I say check that one out. If it's a cover, then I would say check out Fireworks.
Baby, you on fire, you on fire, you on fire, you on fire.
And the new one, you're sitting on a toilet.
The new one sitting on a toilet, yeah.
What was the inspiration of the music video on the toilet?
Because, like, after I had my release party, I had all this leftover toilet paper that said, be careful, this is shit. So what I did was I was like, I got to use this in a video. I was like, I'm just gonna do it in the bathroom. Because when I had the party, I wanted people to come away from my party talking about things. Because, right. You know, people have catering, people seen nice parties. But if you have the toilet paper with the name of the album on it, woo, you're killing them.
That's the way to do it. You're always doing it different.
Drop more knowledge in the bathroom. Then you can get up in your classroom.
I love Love Signs. That's one of my favorite ones that you ever did.
That was great. It was edited by Aaron Moorhead. He's one of my favorite directors that I used to do my videos. And that's an amazing video. I still don't know how he did it.
That was serious. Yeah, I was wondering the same thing. I was just going to ask you.
I don't know.
You all got to check out this video. I don't even want to describe it. I can't do it justice.
It's crazy.
See it and you will see.
And I found me a Leo, the center of attraction everywhere that we go. She loved the living style, dominate the crowd. Every time we go out, she would stay for a while. Demand her respect and love pleasing me. I never seen a lion hurt so easily. And I admit it was scary. So I moved on to an Aries. Little rebel, stubborn little devil.
That was like a high end, like that's a Jay-Z level video.
That's a Jay-Z level video.
Digitour. Now, we were just there. We were interviewing Ricky Ficarelli.
Yeah, Ricky's
and Alex Goot. We were in Austin with him. We heard you join part of the tour.
I jumped on at the tail end of the tour. I did like 8 cities on the end.
How was it?
It was good. It was good to see the fans, and Canada was ridiculous.
Now, where did you sleep? Because we were actually on the bus with like all the bunk beds.
Well, you know,
were you there with everybody?
Yeah, because they got the coffins.
Yep.
I call them the coffins. You know, in that little section.
Oh, we got
right
a
there.
Tour. Ricky gave us a tour, the whole thing.
And you sleep on those, and then you get a little bit of ADHD after you're done, yeah. And a little bit of post-traumatic stress disorder after you're done, because you wake up and you're like, oh my God, am I in one of these coffins? So like 3 days after, it messes you up.
Best story, we were there getting ready to shoot, and we heard a little noise, and someone goes to look, and there was a girl in one of the bunk beds. No one knew who she was.
Just random girl.
Nobody knew how she got there. She was just passed out in the bed, but they actually had to kick her off the bus.
My bad, Karen. I didn't mean to put you in that booth, baby.
Shane Dawson was through here.
Yeah.
We just interviewed Caitlin Gerard.
He lives
all part of Smiley.
Smiley. Michael Gallagher.
He's that trailer is a little, it's a little out there.
Yeah.
You called Smiley and he came.
Something's been awakened. Like something's been born.
What did you think when you first saw Smiley and when you saw what that was gonna look like?
Scary stuff.
Right?
It's gonna be good. Smiley's gonna be good. Make sure y'all check out Smiley the movie. It's gonna be awesome.
Yep. And with Shane, what's it like with him? He was a character when he was through here.
I didn't even know that Shane can act that well.
Right.
I mean, I watched his videos and they use it like jokes and stuff, but then when he was acting on Smiley, I was like believing him. I was like, yeah. Feels good to be his wingman, you know?
Right.
Like, he actually is a good actor, so.
It's cool, like, everyone transforming other platforms. First doing the YouTube thing and now doing these movies.
And now doing movies.
And now, albums.
Albums.
Gotta talk about that. We got a big album that recently.
Be careful. Yeah, be careful is. So I always brand it everywhere and stuff. And when it first dropped, it was like number 9 on the charts.
Where's
like,
the Be Whoa. Careful shirt? I thought we'd be.
I was going to rock one, but I thought it'd
be. He decided to rock the Young Hollywood hat instead, because that's how we do it.
That's how we roll, baby.
That's how we do it. This is your first real, I mean, it's a mixtape, but it's kind of what, 14 songs or how many
it's
are on
there? It's 14 songs plus a bonus.
Okay.
I always say that. I don't know why. People are like, well, why don't you just say 15 songs?
Because that's
their shit, you know? So I like, it's 14 songs plus a bonus, which is like 15 song cuts. And I say the bonus because I had a contest and won a YouTube contest, because that's where my base of audience came from.
Right.
And I, you know, I had the winner of the contest. I had like 1,500, it was a lot of entries. Like 1,200, 1,300 entries, I think, and video entries. And the kid who won, I put him on the album, so.
Nice.
That's that bonus.
If you had to describe yourself in one word, what would that word be?
An inspiration.
There you go. Day power, an inspiration to all.
Holla.
Be good.
Got it.